It's Wednesday. It's the 24th of, what month are we in? April. I'm at the delightful Ridgmont station, which has a tea room and a heritage centre and a whole bunch of other rather charming, attractive features. But mainly what it's got is this. So here's the deal. In this corner here, there's a video. God, it must be like about a year ago now, or maybe like 18 months, that I did a trip up to the Vivarail factory, where they basically took these trains, the old 78 London Underground D-stock trains. Vivarail have converted them. And in that video, I explored how they were turning these trains to run on this and others line, but they started in service yesterday. So it sounds like a D-stock, it kind of looks like a D-stock. Oh, there's some people playing guitar music in there. I wasn't expecting to get to be serenaded almost by guitar music. I put that link in the description. So around the 2:30, but my eyes are drawn. I kind of half expect to see, or I want to see, a district line carriage map up here, but instead, there isn't, but there is. I see that the carriage map is, in fact, there's like an individual. It reminds me of being on, when you're on the 1938 stock on the Isle of Wight, on the tube trains there, there's a much more colourful, characterful map giving detail. So I can see here at every stop, there's a little bit of detail about every stop, and there's some others that pertain. Alicia Miller, who I believe is the artist that designed the toilet. There's like things to do, so there's a picture there about Bletchley Park. A lot of thought has obviously gone into adding a bit more character to the line diagram rather than just having, you know, a boring line diagram. Aspley guys. Famous, of course, at one point for being the least used station. Oh, I'm getting stared at by the conductor. Are those new seats as well? Time to go for a wander, I think, down the train.
There is
space for a bike, fold down seats. There's a toilet, we'll come back to the toilet. There are high back seats in this amazing maquette design. There are some table seats, there are side seats, and more interestingly, can walk between the carriages. And then you come down here and we're at the front of the two-car train. Looks good. What I do like is that there are table seats.
We are now approaching Bedford. Please mind the gap between the train and step onto the platform.
Tia, thank you for watching. Do you think tube trains, like underground trains, should have table seats? How do you like the new train?
It's lovely, so accessible! Finally! Bletchley, we've finally got it.
Okay, bye.
See ya.
Bye.
Stay up here.
She likes it. The only thing I was going to say is that I'm intrigued, if I just go and sit at one of the table seats, I'm intrigued. High back seats. The maquette, Vicky's not with me, so I have sent her a picture of the maquette, but it's the green, there's like a green diamond in it, which to me looks like the diamond shape that's in the London Northwestern logo. But what's nice about it is that the London Northwestern colours happen to be green, and that also gives a slight nod to the district line, which is green. It's good either way. I really like the high back seats, because it's like proper seats, but I then like the way that they've retained some of the old underground style seats as well. It's a nice mix, and fold down seats and toilets. Accessible toilet, by the way, loads of space in there. That customer very happy. It's all good.
I like it.
I've met an ex district line driver called Richard. What do you think?
Very impressive.
Well,
very comfortable seats. Very smooth ride, very quiet. You'd hardly know it was a diesel powered train.
Should they have tables on tube trains?
No.
Excellent answer. departed Bletchley on our way back. We're going to get out of Ridgmont again for a cup of tea. We just saw the two other trains in the shed as we left Bletchley. And that's an advantage which they have. Not only are they going to have a spare, but the trains are now based here. Where did you say they were based before?
Tinsley.
At Tinsley near Birmingham. That's where they had to send the class 1532. So, and now they're based here for maintenance. There's a brilliant poster up there as well about how it says destocked D-Train, and the phrase they're using is upcycled. Will there be more instances of this happening with railways in Britain, where instead of being consigned to the scrap heap, you take an older train and you give it a brilliant refurb, as Vivarail have done, and turn it into an amazing train like this? We could see more of it in the future. Do you commute this line every day?
Every single day, yeah.
Every day. And did you turn up yesterday not knowing that there was a new train? Was
yeah,
it by chance? What happened?
Pretty much.
What happened?
I just come to the train and I said, oh, there's the new one. Because I've seen it commuting like back and forth, and they were like testing out with like the people in orange jackets. And I said, oh my God, it's the new train. So I got on, I was like, wow, this is different.
We got to Ridgmont and it's raining. Oh, it's really raining. See you guys.
See you
on the return. See you on the return. You get the dramatic shot in the rain of the 2:30 departing. So we made it to Ridgmont. Ridgmont has a little sort of heritage room slash museum slash place of interest, and also tea rooms. And a nice gentleman down there is making us all a cup of tea. Just do a quick 360 spin around so you can see what's going on here. And there's a nice man called Stephen that we're gonna go and have a quick chat with.
Hello.
You are the Community Rail Officer for the Marston Vale line. Have I got that correct?
Marston Vale Community Rail Punch Officer. Yes, pretty much.
How? I know you're excited.
We are very excited.
I'm setting you up. How excited are you about the new trains?
Well, we've been talking about these new trains for what seems like years and years and years.
Yeah.
So now they're finally here. It's fantastic. I've been riding on them myself yesterday and also today. They're just so light and airy, much better facilities for passengers. And one of the best things I think about them is all the information on them about what you can do on our fantastic line, the Heritage Centre behind me here at Ridgmont,
yep.
All the walks you can do, all the attractions you can visit.
Like, I realised about the tea rooms, I didn't realise there was a little museum.
Yeah,
the
museum as well.
The museum's great. So there's a shop, a tea room, and then there's this in here. This is John. So, hello, John.
Hi.
He's let us in. This is the old general waiting room, which is now... this is a ticket office window, so clearly this was a ticket office too. It's now a little tiny museum. So basically, come and ride the Bedford to Bletchley line, ride the new Vivarail Class 230, and get out at Ridgmont, have a cup of tea, and check out their museum. Perfect. So that is Ridgmont, thanks Stephen. It's a brilliant place to come and have like a little railway adventure, have an adventure day out. Here comes our train. Back on the train, back on the district line, sorry, back on the Marston Vale line, gonna head for Bletchley. It's like the district line, but not. It's quiet, it's so good, you wouldn't know that you're on a diesel train, I'll say that. It feels, you get sucked into the whole district line thing, you feel like you're on an electric train, but it is a really quiet. It is a really quiet diesel train. Loving it.
Toilet door is locked.
Is it what the toilet looks like, by the way? It's just a toilet.